Well, I thought that it's some kind of the international police who are making arrests. I never thought about it as a database. So, less than 2 years after I started working on the in the Anti-Corruption Foundation, a criminal case against me was started. So I left, and this is how the story. And I left Russia, and I went to the other country, finally to Lithuania. But this is how the story with Interpol begins.
Interpol tabii ki duymuştum. Interpol'ü kırmızı bülten olduğunu, hatta değişik renk bültenleri olduğunu da biliyordum. Ama benim kendim böyle bir şeyin içerisinde olduğumu bilmiyordum. Hatta kendi kendime demiştim, Çakal Carlos mesela, kırmızı bülten, seri katiller, işte ne bileyim çok aranan insanlar, böyle insanlar mı sadece benim gözümde yani suçlu olabilecek kapasitede insanlar belki de Interpol'lü olabilir ama ben kendimi hiç öyle bir yerde düşünmemiştim yani. Yani bir anda kopuyor, bütün yaşantı koptuğu bir yer yani.
We saw that there were simple changes that Interpol could adopt, especially in relation to refugees who'd fled their homes, often fearing for their lives. They only found themselves later on to be targeted by the regimes that they had fled through Interpol. So it's great to see that Interpol have been listening to our concerns, and these changes mean a lot to refugees in particular.
...2012'de Interpol araması nedeniyle tutuklandım ve büyük bir haksızlığa sadece ben değil bütün ailecek uğramış olduk. Yaşamımda gerçekten en kötü dönüm noktası diyebilirim. 2008'de hakkımda Interpol araması çıkartılmış. Bundan benim haberim yoktu tabii ki. Ama Ocak 2017'de kaldırılmış oldu. Yani benim yaşamımı tekrar bana hediye ettiler diyebilirim.
Interpol deserve credit for the improvements that they've adopted, especially in relation to refugees. But this is only the beginning. There's much more to be done.
I was at least in one country, I was at the local national database of the border control, and they arrested me based on their own records in their database. I got the confirmation from Interpol, but due to the reason that this is not the red notice, but it's just the diffusion request, it's like an email. Nobody controls it. Russia just makes the email stating my name, stating my documents, number of my document numbers or whatever, and other details, my picture, sending them to all of the national offices, national bureaus of the Interpol in every country. And it's up to the country, whatever, to proceed with this diffusion request or not. Cyprus did that. And I, for the rest of my life, I don't have the guarantee, and nobody, nor Interpol, nor Russia, nobody will ever assure me that I will not face the same situation.